Okay, standard score, z-score, is, reading this to you, it calculates how many standard deviations away from the mean for a measurement in a population or sample, and we call that measurement x. It could be any measurement in the sample. A negative z-score would mean the measurement is to the left of the mean, and a positive z-score means the measurement is to the right of the mean. And so you can compare data that doesn't necessarily coincide with each other. So here's an example of that. Let me pull that up. So here's an example. A student scored, kind of what I mean, a student scored 65 on a calculus test that had a mean of 50 and a standard deviation of 10. So that was one nasty test. Then she scored 30 on a history test with a mean of 25 and a standard deviation of 5. So, how did she do on that? Compare her relative positions on the two tests. So what we do on that is we'll calculate the z-score. So z is equal to, and I guess I didn't flash those equations up enough. I need to pull them back so you can kind of see them. So z-score is calculated by taking the value that we're wanting minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. And that, so for a sample, you'd use x bar for mean and s for sample. And for if you had the entire population, you'd use mu for mean and sigma for standard deviation. Okay, so that we know the equations. Whoa, it's the wrong thing. And so back to our problem. So we know a z-score, she scored a 65. That was her measurement. So 65 minus the mean of that test was a 50 divided by her standard deviation of 10. And so her z-score for the calculus test was 15 over 10, which is 1.5. Okay, so that's her standard position or standard score or z-score for that particular test. And maybe I'll put a little calc beside it so we know it's the calculus test. Now the history test, you figure the same way. So she scored a 30. So z score on the history exam was a 30. The mean was a 25. And the standard deviation is 5. And so her z-score in that case would be 5 over 5, which is 1 on the history exam. Okay, so because her standard position was further to the right in the calculus exam, she did better relatively on the calculus exam than she did on the history exam. So you can kind of make some comparisons there. And so that's probably something you'd want to write out too then. Write that in words so that it makes sense to anybody reading this. So I explained it, but since the z-score for calculus is larger, her relative position in the calculus class is higher, than her relative position in her history class, in the history class. So essentially finding out, not a rank necessarily, but she is higher. She's in a higher position in her calculus class than she is in her history class. So there you go. That's z-score. We're going to use z-score a lot in this particular class, and so that's a very important measurement that we will see again and again and again. So hope this helps. Good luck, and see you next time.